mail. Who got their Icon pass? I got mine this week, and I already made my little gondola. Oh, my snowboard's falling off. Uh-oh. I got my pass, and my stickers. Another sticker. Where do you guys put these? I'm curious. I haven't decided. This might go on my water bottle, but it's kind of big. Something like this might be better on the bottle. Yeah, let me know. Where do you guys stick your stickers? And then it came with this poster, which if I had a ski cabin, it would be going in. And the map with all of the Icon places. And I already checked off the eight places that I've been. I need to add some more dots this year. Where should I go? Let me know. Because the Icon pass arrived this week, I am in a skiing mood and realized that I didn't post any of my skiing videos from earlier this year because I went to, let's see, 5 Icon places this year and 1 private club. I thought I would put a video together on each of my experiences there, starting with the big 3 in Banff. Around noon and couldn't check into our hotel, so we decided to do a hike at Johnston Canyon. When we got to the lower falls of Johnston Canyon, there was a long lineup to go through the cave and look at the falls. It took us about 30 minutes as people were going through the cave in small groups because where the cave opens up to see the falls is a very small platform. Because we were by the water, and it was misty, but everything was also frozen. The air was extremely cold. So I did a lot of jumping jacks to keep warm. When it was finally our turn to go through the cave, there's a couple of steps you have to go up, and they were just completely covered in ice. I literally crawled up on my hands and knees.
Oh, I think I reached 10,000 steps.
Already?
Yeah. Well, I was doing aerobics in the lineup.
Johnston Canyon is a beautiful place to go to no matter what the season, and I highly recommend going, but just be aware that it is extremely touristy now, and over the holidays, you're going to have to expect some lineups. We went to Banff in early January, thinking that everyone was finished their winter break. That was not correct. Alberta still had another week left, so it was a little bit more crowded than we expected. Thankfully, we had booked reservations at all the restaurants that we wanted to go to. We stayed at the Canalta. Canalta looks great, has some great amenities. It's been redone recently, but my room did not have a closet. Nor did it have a coat rack or any hooks. Yeah, it catered to skiers. I'm still trying to figure that one out. Everything else was fantastic about the Canalta, hands down. Service impeccable. So our first night we booked the Grizzly for our fondue dinner. We heard some good things. Interesting place. Think you should go there and discover it for yourself. Ask some questions. You'll be intrigued, I think. The fondues were great. Would definitely return.
Zamboni crossing.
Love about sunshine. My description of Sunshine Valley in Banff is it is a playground for giants. You go up the Continental Divide lift and then you're just out there. The sun is shining, at least it was when I was there. There's sparkles in the air from the snow lightly falling or blowing, I'm not sure. And it's just this valley that's open. And I imagine these big yetis stomping around and picking up snowballs and tossing it at each other. This is where my mind went when I went to Sunshine Valley. And I loved it.
What the hell was that? So I'm standing in front of the symbol with Charlotte. She wants me to go down. Now, it doesn't look too bad. But, oh my god, I hit the blackout sign. This looks like fun. You think we should do it?
Yeah.
Okay. Alrighty, here we go.
The snow was pretty good, even though it was still a little early January. There were a couple of little treetops sticking out here or there. But that doesn't matter. I mean, it was real snow. Real snow. And anything out there is better than here. Sorry, Ontario. There's skiing or snowboarding for everyone there, all levels. Again, giant playground, just think of it. And there's some really good terrain for those who like to do that. And you can't be bored there. Skipping the gondola to go down to the car at the end of the day. Do yourself a favor, take the path down. It is such a beautiful glide with a beautiful view. It just makes your experience last a little bit longer. So, big three, Sunshine Valley was first. Loved it. After we skied at Sunshine Village, we had reservations at the Juniper. That is such a cool place. The food is great, the service is great, the ambiance is great, it's attached to a hotel. Today we went to Norquay. It's part of the big three. It's close to Banff where we were staying. What did I love about Norquay? That was a toughie. To summarize the experience, you go to Norquay for four reasons. One, first of all, it seems to be really popular with families. Two, it seems to be where a lot of the racing takes place. Three, there is a section of Norquay, a lift that is purely black diamond runs and very technical. So I was told that that is popular for a lot of people who want to do their technical skiing and challenge themselves. Get that. I saw the hill, it looked really challenging. I don't think it was open because of the ski or the snow conditions. For people like me, I thought, let's do all of the big three.
How is that going around those children? Wasn't that hell? I almost knocked about six of them over.
It's the extra obstacle course, you know.
Norquay also just wasn't a great experience for us. The snow wasn't great compared to sunshine. It was overcrowded. Some of the lifts weren't running. Saw somebody fall off a lift. That gave us some concern. And overall, we weren't having a great time. We did it, we experienced it. Moving on. We left Norquay and went back to Sunshine Village and had a great day. Our splurge dinner was the Sky Bistro on top of Sulphur Mountain. We also booked this in advance, as well as the gondola, which you need to take up to the Sky Bistro. Regardless of having reservations, the parking lot was packed. People were parking in an auxiliary parking lot, which made the walk a little longer. And we found parking on the way into the parking lot where people were parking and seemed to be okay. When we got into this gondola station, even with our reservations, we were early, and yet the lineup to get in put us into a later time than we expected, and therefore we didn't have enough time to walk around up there outside. If you want the full experience, book the gondola well in advance of your dinner reservation and show up well in advance of the gondola reservation. The restaurant was chef's kiss. The food was great, service was great. We were there before sunset, so we had the view. We were seated right next to the window, and we got to watch the sunset from the restaurant. It was great. The whole experience was fantastic. The dessert looked like a sculpture and tasted like what a sculpture would taste like. I don't know, but you'll have to try it. After the dinner, we walked around. There was some room with trippy lights. I didn't understand what was going on there, but we tried to immerse ourselves in it. And then we headed back down. That same night that we would go to the hot springs, Banff Hot Springs, because it was really close to where the gondola was. Here's our mistake. It was Saturday night, and the last Saturday off of a winter break. Who knew that people partied at the hot springs? Well, we do now. So my recommendation is go during the day. Prior to this, that's the only time I've gone, and there was plenty of room. And definitely don't go on an evening of a holiday. It was like being at a nightclub. There were youth eyeing each other. It was jam-packed. We were lucky enough to get a seat, and the couple next to me, which were not youth, were making out, possibly more. Yeah, that happened. Sunday was a non-skiing day. We took the day to wander the town, look at the shops, be a tourist. We went to Secret Lookout, we went to the Fairmount, we had a little, I don't know, après lunch at the Rundle Bar. Highly recommend that as well. We lucked out again with a window seat. That night, we ate at Chuck's Steakhouse. I had the ribs, my friend had the Wagyu steak. Again, service was great, the food was great. I would definitely go back there again. I have only great things to say about Lake Louise. I felt like I was home again. It reminded me of the hills that I grew up with, even though it was much bigger than the likes of Silver Star, Apex, Mount Baldy. But there was definitely a familiar vibe about the ski hill. Now, we waited a day because there was snow in the forecast, so we got there on a pow day. Yes. Credit because Alberta went back to school. I could ski Lake Louise over and over and over again and not get bored. Are great. The snow is great. There's lots of options. There's the front side, the back side, the front of the back side. I loved the cafe on the back side. I liked some of the challenging runs and then mixing it up with some easy going runs. You name it, Lake Louise has it. And Lake Louise, how do you make a choice between the two? After skiing at Lake Louise, we went down to the lake itself, where the Fairmount is. After that, we went back to Banff for the rest of the evening to do some après-ski hot tubbing. Okay, enough about the big three. We made it home, yay! And I'd like to highlight another ski hill that I'd never been to before called Osler. It is in Collingwood area, and I guess you would call it south of Blue Mountain, but part of that whole Blue Mountains range. It's a private members club. I had the opportunity to go with a group, and oh my gosh, what can I say? It's a small hill, but it's not crowded. So you can go on the lift and come down. Go on the lift and come down without waiting in line or barely waiting in line. Exploring a little bit, I found a powder hill that no one was skiing on. So I spent a good chunk of time there just going up and down this beautiful run. The snow was mine. I got to carve my own tracks, make my own path. Yeah, good experience. And everyone was so friendly there. I did ski at Blue this year, and I will again because that is my local Icon ski hill. What do I love about Blue Mountain? The lineups, the ice. My three favorite things about Blue Mountains are the people I ski with or snowboard with, the beaver tails at the top of the hill, and the orchard lift when it's open. If I were to add a fourth thing, the north end of Blue Mountain when it has snowed. Did you know that Toronto had a ski hill? I've worked for the City of Toronto teaching skiing at Earl Bales for the past couple of years. It's a really sweet hill. The instructors are superb, and it's a great place to learn. Going to Mont Tremblant in the spring has become an annual tradition. This year, it turned out that a few of my friends were also going to be in Tremblant at the same time. We met up and did some runs together. Love about Mont Tremblant. Restaurant. Well, I love the little village. The quality of snow tends to be pretty good there. Love the length of the runs, the variety of the runs. That's so gorgeous. The lines aren't very long compared to, well, that's not true. The most fun and gracious host had a couple of us up to their hunting lodge, aka Maple Forest, aka Maple Syrup Sugar Shack. I'll just say it. I am Canadian and I do love maple syrup. The whole weekend was spent exploring the acreage, collecting tree sap, eating, and watching the hunters transform that sweet, sweet tree sap into the good stuff, maple syrup. That leaves me with these stickers if I choose to put them on. I would definitely put the Yeti on, but I don't have room for that either. So I'm left with these mountains. I'm thinking this bright yellow icon just to add some more pop to this bottle. Leaving me much room for more stickers. So again, I ask you, where else do you put all your cool stickers?